Today we're going to be making this guy here. As you can tell, he is a monkey. And so I will be showing you how to do the head bases. So to start with, you need some 1-inch foam. Oh, this is a non-moving jaw, by the way, so it'll just be foam carving. So you need your hot glue gun. It's going at the moment. Good boy. For measuring this out, I just grabbed a tape measure and measured around my own head. And this guy is 3 centimeters bigger than my head. So I just made sure you add extra and then even more extra, because when this folds around, obviously it loses its length because it's thicker than a tape measure. So I add probably about 20 centimeters extra when cutting this out lengthways, and for heightways 30 centimeters is roughly about average for most heads. And when I curl it up and put it around my head, let's see if I can do this. This is a new camera, so I'm stuck. There's my head. Hey, when I wrap it around and put it on my head,
It seems to fit quite snugly. Quite snugly, yes.
And because his head is 3 centimeters bigger than mine, I think that this should fit quite perfectly on him. And yes, then I just went and cut all these notches, because this is going to be the top of the head. So there, you can see I'm cutting it out now. Choop, choop, choop. These will be the notches of the head to kind of concave inwards, and then I add another little piece of foam on the top for the base of the head. Yes.
Know where the camera is, but I think it's around here somewhere.
So yeah, it's still pretty loose on the inside there. Should be good. So I just kind of eyeball it, like, oh yeah, about that big. Does it look like a monkey yet? Monkey head. So I've kind of drawn a bit of a design on it of where I think the eyes and nose and teeth will go. And I put my head in it first and then kind of like poke myself in the eye through the foam to figure out where the eyes should be for when you're actually wanting to see out of them. So you can see I've kind of taken a nick. There we go. I've taken a nick out of that one and a little nick out of that. That's because I like kind of pinch where my eyes are and pull out a bit of foam so I know exactly where I was seeing out of. So yeah, that's basically kind of where the eyes should go. And now I'm going to cut out each of the eyes. Oh, I've got to try this on. Ooh. Look at that grin. That's gonna be fun to make. Extending the face out further.
I like to love you night and day, if I may.
snuggle it into place. So sparkly.
Hazum, 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 h
then it was done.
Hooray!
My hair keeps getting in the way. Damn it!
I have long hair now.
Ta-da!
It's gonna look so good though with the fur. It's gonna make this volume out so much. It's a monkey, damn it. One job. Oh, rude.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Oh, more time. Marker.
Marker.
Yeah.
Markiplier. How's Scott? It's a mesh. See-through mesh. See? You see-through.
Good bugger, man.
This one blue. Dark blue mesh. Yeah, man. Okay, next thing. We did like the whole face. Ta-da. This is a monkey face. Can you tell monkey face? Monkey looks scary. Anyway. Monkey face. All hands on. See, these are the eyebrow bits. And it all hands on. Including the nose, which was very hard. I sewed the nose because Maria would fuck it up.
Pardon?
Nothing.
What did you say?
And then this goes on this. Yay, oh yeah, I also do cutting out mouth piece. And glue inside mouth. Bleh.
Because you're cool.
Yeah, and then this is like glued to this ridge here.
This ridge.
This ridge here, yes. And then this, I hold with feet. Fuck. This will go on this like this. Oh shit, there's foam everywhere. This is impossible when I only have
oh,
and then see, done. This is monkey.
Ta-da.
This is monkey head. Shut up. Okay, well, I accidentally forgot to record me putting on the micro fleece face, attaching it to the foam, but what I pretty much did was the whole thing was pretty much like a sock. It was all sewn together, and I started right here. I put the hot glue right on the nose, the creasy part there, and I stuck the fleece on there. So the face is kind of like, the whole head is in two parts. You've got like the front face part and then the back of the head and all this hair and whatnot. So I put those on separately. I put the face on first just to get that out of the way, since it's like, it was probably the most hardest part to do. You see it's got nice little wrinkles here, and I just had to put those on slowly using a bit of hot glue at a time. I just moved probably about an inch at a time, putting a little bit more of the fleece on. And then, it's kind of hard to see around the eyes, I'll just move around. Yeah, so these just match up to the black inside the head. I can't actually remember if I showed putting on the black of the head either, but, okay, let's have a look. Here's the black fabric inside the head. Maria taped up the inside, or half of the inside.
You're welcome!
And then, yeah, we cut that out and she glued that all in. So it's nice and fabric-y inside, instead of like foamy.
Yes, that's it.
Yeah, so that got done. I actually did show, I did show putting on the blue inside of the mouth. And then, yeah, now the fleece, the micro fleece is all done as well. Yay! So yeah, I put the head on. I ended up sewing
this side of the ear. I sewed that the front side of the ear onto the fur on here just to give it a bit more stability, because normally ears that are a bit thicker, I can just glue the ear straight on without having to worry about sewing it anywhere. But since this ear was so thin, I thought I should at least sew it in one place. So yeah, it's been sewn here, but not on the back, because that's what I used as my halfway mark. So this is a separate piece that's all been sewn together and attached, and then this is a separate piece that's all been sewn and attached. Yeah, I made him some ear gauges. What's it called? Gauges? Gauges? Gauges!
Apparently it's pronounced gauge. Gauges.
Okay.
With rage.
Rage, gauge. Okay, ear gauges. That's what they're called. Even though I have ear gauges in my own ear, I still don't actually know what they're called.
We just call them stretchers. Like,
yeah.
Stretchers.
I'll show the back of his head.
Oh, yeah, the hairstyle.
Here's the hairstyle. Whoop, it's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5-ish peaks down the middle, and then hard to see, but there's like 2-ish on this side. One is kind of right there, and then this one's another one. That's one, this is one, this is one, and then this is one here too. Oh, that's a cool thing you can do with it also. You can use a bit of it's a water-based hair gel that's quite like liquidy, and you can just brush it out easily, but you can use that gel and spike these up a bit into stiffer points, and that looks quite cool, especially like that front one there, which can be like that. Woohoo! And then of course you can see I glued the gem in already as well, so it looks quite dark in some areas like that. You can't really see anything, but as soon as the light hits it, it goes a goldeny color. Woo! Pretty fly! Pretty fly! And right now, oops, got some orange on his nose. Right now, I am in the middle of making his teeth, so I've decided I'm not going to do them with Super Sculpey or Dew Kit, which is a polymer clay, because I was actually just looking at my clay and looking at the mouth thinking, ugh, that's actually going to probably be way too much clay to stick inside of a mouth, and it'll weigh him down quite a bit. So instead, I've decided to make the teeth out of the stuff over here, which is a fake leather, but it's quite nice and durable, and if it gets a little bit mucky, you can just wipe it clean. Yeah, so we'll see how that goes. There's the teeth pattern I made. These are for the bottom teeth. Where's this reference picture? Yes, so yeah, the bottom teeth here is what I just cut out, and then I'll make a top version that will go around the outsides of these ones. But I'll make these first and install them, and then do that one second. And then I'll probably make, he's got like some little molary bits on the side, so I'll probably make those separate as well and put those in. Whoop! I made the teeth! Didn't have time to bother filming me put the teeth in, but all I essentially did was hot glue them in, and pulling on them, that's literally all they need. They're quite well attached. I just finished the tongue, and the tongue has two magnets in it, so it's got half a magnet right at the top here, and then it's got another magnet right on the back. So this top one, there's a magnet on the roof of the mouth, so when I do that, bleh, you can be doing the bleh face. And when I take this back out, it's got that magnet, so I'll put that, oops, top one tries to stick on first, nope, you'll go on the bottom. So now this will be his casual look. So you just see a little bit of tongue, you don't see a whole lot. And I wonder if that would work. Yeah, it kind of does work actually. I hadn't thought about that. The half a magnet sticks on the magnet that's on the bottom jaw, and then it can kind of be like a poking out slash loose look. But I think the bleep probably looks the cutest, so I like to do bleep, this one. Oh, shit.